later. Boom.
What games do I like on PC? I like a lot of games on PC. I mean, I was just talking up The Witness a whole bunch. All right. So. Let's get this going. Bring this over here. Bring that. This can just be X'd. Bring this and this. And this. Oh, man. Braid? I really liked some stuff about Braid. I didn't end up finishing it because I got kind of sick of it before I finished it. But Braid was pretty cool. All right, games, AM2R, boom. A controller is recommended. Please don't tell me how to play video games. I don't like when video games themselves backseat me on how to play them. We really recommend you use a controller for our game. Yo, I'll decide that, all right? Okay, now the game went away, but it's still being captured. How is this happening? Like, if I go over to it, you guys can see it. This window does not exist on my PC, though. It is nowhere to be found. It also sounds really loud. But still, what is happening? Alt tab? There it is. Okay, wonderful. There we go. Oh, it kind of found the controller. Oh, look at that. Control options. Okay. Aiming style, two buttons, switches between Zero Mission and Super Metroid style aiming. Oh gosh, I guess I prefer Zero Mission. Wait. Aim diagonally using two separate buttons, press up or down to choose direction. Oh, they do it Super Metroid by default? Yeah, that'll be better. Toggle and hold. Yeah, we'll do toggle if we're doing two buttons. Classic morph ball. Press morph to activate. Oh, no. Enable. Classic. Spider ball. Toggle. Auto climb. Hold downwards when running against a tunnel? Alright, fine. What I'm looking for is this. Analog walking. Let's just disable that because we're not using analog sticks. Now, jump is going to be this button. We need to make it like Super Metroid. Aim up. Guys, how did Super Metroid do it? Which one was up and which one was down? I feel like L was up and R was down. I don't know what aim lock is, but I guess we're not going to use it. Weapon select is... Actually, it should be this. What are you saying, Sin? I'm saying, did L aim up or down? Alright, weapon cancel, that is select. Start is that button. Menu accept is this button. And menu back is that button. Done. Okay. You think R was up and L was down? I wonder. Let's check really quick. Super Metroid. You guys can see my desktop. Ugh. All right. In Super Metroid, L is down and R is up. Oh, look at that. All right, done. We figured it out. A little dead man's party.
Oh, geez. Oh no, look at that. Whoa, fuck.
I think we're about to get going on this game, now that I'm getting the controls down. I'm sorry this is taking so long. I thought we were gonna play Metroid 2 for a little longer. I thought we were gonna play Final Fantasy 3 for a little longer. Alright, let's plug the SNES controller back in. Okay, so, anyway, aiming style, whoa, that should be two buttons. Missile select style, toggle. We did all this stuff. Okay, joypad settings, let's just make sure. Now that I have menus done correctly, let's do this. Jump, that button. Fire, that button. Aim up was, fuck, now I forgot. R, aim down is L. Aim lock and morph aren't things that we do. Weapon select is that button. Weapon cancel is that button. Start is this button. Accept. Back. Done. Okay, we can play now. Wonderful. What are these? Display scale. Wait, full screen is enabled.
Whoa!
Cool. Alright. New game. Normal.
Metroids. Numerous incidents in the past have brought to light the highly destructive power of these life forms, spreading fear across all known planetary systems. Hoping to secure peace in the galaxy, the Galactic Federation orders the extermination of the Metroid species. I was the best candidate for the job. Once again, I find myself standing alone against the Metroid menace. What horrors await me within the depths of their home world?
Oh yeah, Psycrab, you're allowed to backseat. Yeah, so this is on the Zero Mission engine, I hear, so it's like Game Boy Advance graphics, essentially. All right, so here we are. We got our Metroid aiming. Ooh. Oh yeah. Okay. These are definitely the stiff ass Metroid Zero Mission controls. Yep. Metroid Zero Mission had very stiff controls. Oh, that's what aim lock is. Okay, that's not in a very good spot, but that's fine. We're on a Super Nintendo controller, so whatever. Oh, I know, Sai. Alright, so here we go. So far, the pixel art is on fucking point. We don't have bombs yet. All right. Wait a minute. This is just like Metroid 2 so far. Oh man, and the music is the same. But it's actually music happening. We'll see if it cuts out like it did in the other one. But yeah, this is exactly, we just did this, remember? When we had to go down a whole bunch? And then you get here and you can morph ball through here. But we... Oh yeah, the aim lock is like the moonwalk in Super Metroid. That's what they called it, right? So, if my Metroid 2 experience tells me anything, it is that we go this way first. Right, compared to my map. We'll see. It'll be fun to compare. But yeah, so far it's the same. Just, I had the scale kind of off when I first started, and so that first little stretch to the right, I had kind of a little too big. But actually, I don't know. Whoop, whoop. Go left and shoot. Psycrab, what do you think of, what do you think of horseshoe crabs? I saw some today and I was a little disturbed. Oh, only takes one missile to open a missile door. That's fantastic. Is this a save point? Yes, it is. Oh shit, Psycrab, you could be a Pokemon, like Psyduck. You've never seen one? You never actually seen one, or do you mean like you've never even seen a picture of one? Oh geez. What, do we have to hit him in the bottom? Press B to open the logbook. I'm pressing B. Oh, does this game not know what a Super Nintendo controller is? Oh my god. Hang on. It couldn't really figure out when I crouched in the corner. Okay, what button does this game think B is? Because it was not that. Oh no, it said button 8. It wasn't B, that was an 8. Because it thinks, because this is a direct input controller. Oh, don't look them up, they're gross. Horseshoe crabs, that is. Okay, so far I'm having a wonderful time with this game. It's just, it, so far it's just like Metroid 2, except the controls and the graphics are, and the, everything is just like super good. Whoop. I'm wondering about how I have the controls set up though. Like, I do really like the way that the Game Boy Advance does it, where you hold R to do missiles, and then you hold L and just press up or down to change the direction, which is like, which is a super great way to do it. But when you have four buttons, having a button that just toggles missiles is, I think, a little bit easier. Oh right, we can just do this. Whoa, the morph ball has like a Metroid Prime thing going on. That's cool. Got those little mud crab ears. The hell are these things? Whoa! Whoa, there's so many different creatures. Oh, here's those things that I got hit by a bunch. These little, like, Mega Man 2 enemies from Metal Man stage. Every time I see an enemy like that, that's exactly the first thing I think of. Flying raccoons. Whoa! 4 Metroids detected in the area. Oh. That's a lot. You know what? We should actually remember what I already knew. Wait a minute. No, I don't have Morph Ball Bombs yet. So if this is Metroid 2, the game should gate me really soon. Needing to know that. Oh my god, Crab. Crow. Are you still on that boss? Frankly, that sounds awesome. Unless the boss feels shitty. Ah, yes, now we're indoors. This is a big part of Metroid 2, is going inside of places. So this should now... There seem to be a lot more, save points in this version. Yep, okay, so that one... I'm gonna peek at my map that I had before. You know, this is fun. It's a little comparison. Here we go. So I went a straight way. Yeah. Okay. Let's look at the game map now. Ah, I've done nothing wrong. You see the spot right there where you can clearly go down in kind of the middle? That's where there's lava. I'm gonna do something for this game, by the way. How's that? So, in the middle there, that's where there's lava. And then we come up and we come indoors right here. And that is just like the original. Oh, okay, yeah. Enjoy your wrestling. I hope Neville doesn't let you down. We, do not have Charge Beam. I don't think you did at this point in the other one anyway. Oh, are these Metroid Zero Mission assets? They look familiar. Maybe not all of them, but definitely some of them. Definitely probably some of them. So we gotta go up this way first, I believe. Hopefully. We'll find ourselves something sweet. Okay, so this is the logbook. Oh, look at this shit. This temple stands at the base of a hollow mountain. The statues, carved stones, and its solid design attest that the structure was built to be a sanctuary, possibly with religious significance. The temple has withstood the test of time, showing the building knowledge and experience of the Chozo. Scans detect the presence of stationary robotic entities placed at strategic points inside the structure. No control signals are detected. These units are operating autonomously. Yeah. Oh, my balls itch.
Alright. So, oh, there's a bunch of shit in the logbook. Oh, man.
Remember the Alpha Metroid? The Alpha Metroid has gained immunity to cold temperatures. The loss of several nuclei within its green membrane have left it vulnerable to a concussive weaponry. A plated exoskeleton partially covers it. This organism emerges from the molting of its larval form. Though aggressive, it is relatively weak at this stage, and its new appendages have yet to grow to their full length and strength.
Whoa! And here's you. Can we turn shit off?
Yes, I love that.
That's something I loved about Super Metroid that was weird about. I think in Zero Mission, you couldn't turn stuff off. Alright, are you guys seeing screen tearing? Because I'm seeing some. I gotta do something. I gotta hop off to my NVIDIA control panel and limit my frame rate to 60. Yes. Evga, there you are. Frame rate, 60. Enable it. There we go. And now we have that shit. Oh, you can set markers. Weird. Menu. Options. Display. Now we turn on VSync, and it VSyncs. Then we turn off VSync, because now it should be synced, and it's set to 60. Fuck! Alright, we'll just turn on VSync then. Whoops. Yeah, that's better. Okay. Did I accidentally make a marker again? Damn it. There. Whoa! Well, that was sweet. Alright, so here we go. Well, this looks great. This is a lot like Zero Mission. It's doing things that I like. I don't know. I don't know what to say about this except that it's excellent so far. It's very fun. And, you know, it's nice to have a new Metroid game to play. Even if it's kind of old, but check it out, man. It's so upgraded that it's basically the same. It's so snappy, too. I really like the controls. Like, it's very snappy. It is also very stiff, just like Zero Mission was. But that's fine. I mean, that's kind of what makes it so snappy. Now, that means that I got the thing in there, right? There's that old Metroid hidden gate. Oh, and that's why all these things are like that, because now we need the things to get back up. To destroy the things, I mean. On the way down, it was just fun, but on the way back up, you have to. What's this? What? Ooh. Would you look at that? Oh, and you can skip that? Cool. Let's go down first. Oh, okay. I actually totally wasn't expecting there to just be a secret right there. Ooh, boy. Oh, wow, and then the missile tanks just fly by. Man, it's like somebody who really likes Metroid made this game. and like really just knows what Metroid needed in some situations. Okay, so now we can hop. Oh, weird, you can actually see like the turnaround thing. This is interesting though. Oh, all right. So this will blow both of them up, but still propel me upward. Got it. Then we just wait it out. All right, this is great. And there's the spider ball. Ooh, so it's like giving me hints and stuff. Cool. I'm shooting shit just because it's fun. This is pretty great so far. Let's take that thing out. The reveal of that spider ball makes me want to go this way. I don't want to leave this half-assed, though. I should be doing my normal thing where I explore entire rooms before I go into doors. I don't know why I haven't been doing that. What is this? Where are you? Hello. Oh. Well then. I'll diddle with that in a minute. Oops. Damn. Yo, every game you gotta get the timing back on the morph ball bombs. Okay, so I am like trying to do control this like zero mission just because it does feel like that a lot. So hey, there's the charge beam. Nice. I wonder if this does the screw attack kind of thing that Super Metroid did, where the charge beam essentially gives you a screw attack, kind of. Like if you're charged up and you jump into something, they get hit by the damage. Okay. Not sure about that yet. Woo! I wish that door was marked on my map that I haven't been through yet since I saw it, but I guess that would give away the secret to somebody who didn't see it. Get up there if I had the ice beam. A lot of save points. I wonder if that's a difficulty thing. Like, I wouldn't expect it to be, but I feel like it's a lot of save points. And it really makes me, does make me wonder. Oh, there it is. Okay, R or L. All right, wonderful. So that means that there's weird stuff like I'm gonna want to get up here and climb all the way around. So yeah, in this kind of situation, it really helps to have a map, because I remember doing a lot of this kind of climbing on the Game Boy version, and it's just tough to space out exactly how big of an area it is that you're in. Alright, well, I'm glad we found that. So we had to do that, that means. And we still have... Oh, and now to climb further, we have to go in here. Oh, and that prevents us from climbing further. That's clever. I mean, that's... Because I haven't tested it, that is assuming that this all hurts you. Yep, okay. Yep, yep. Ah! However, if we open that up, we can climb out this way. Ooh. And look where that brought us. Okay, this is a place we could have gotten to earlier. Right. So in here. Yes, yes, I remember this. Even just from, what is that now? Even just from Metroid 2, this is familiar. Okay, so we've already been here. Alright, so it's just looping around. I see. But, if we go all the way, what I'm hoping is that a bomb will show what we need to do to that thing. But I guess not! So there's a thing we don't have. But I already got those other three things. And that will allow me to go the other way. Super Mario World 2 is on their final quest to defeat the evil Ranger in Dino Thunder? I don't think that's what Super Mario World 2 is. No, 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 no. You're getting the different colored Yoshis mixed up with the different colored Rangers. Yeah. Oh, I got it. All right. Okay, so that seems to be this area. Now let's go back, because we have the spider ball, and did we not even have morph ball bombs before? I think that was the case. I don't remember if save points restored your health, so I guess we'll find out soon enough. I'll start trying to pay attention to that. They do. Good to know. Metroid Prime style. Wait a minute. I see what's happening there. They want me to do this. Hello. Well, I guess that's not what they wanted me to do, but it worked. New log entry. Ooh, the breeding grounds. Oh, shit. Brambles.
An old nemesis.
Ah, hi. Holy shit. Hang on. The old crouch and aim upward. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Whoop. Pew-whoop. Pew-whoop.
Okay.
Okay, I remember all this. Yes, yes, there's three Metroids here. This is just like Metroid 2. Bah! I still don't have the ice beam, though. Remember when I got that right away? I wonder if that's just like a actual design change that they did with this. Or if I just went a different way and didn't realize it. I mean, let's take a look. Let's see. My map shows that there's this building here that has the three ways to go. And the ice beam is where it had the... Wait, there's the spider ball. Yeah, that's where the ice beam was. Okay. I'll show you with the marker. Oops. Right here. This is where the original game had the ice beam. But in this game, that was something else. That was the charge beam in this one. Which I want to say in... Did the regular game have the charge beam already unlocked? No, it did not. So, that's this place done. It does say that there's one more Metroid around here. Oh, yeah, it's not this place done. There's this way to go. Bah. Okay. Oh, boy. This one's kicking my ass. Ugh! I have to run. What the fuck? That one kicked the shit out of me. These things are very difficult to deal with. The way that you have to hit them on the bottom, but they swoop at you? That's tough. Good thing we don't have to, like, go farm out shit. We can just hit the save point. And then go try again. I don't know if it was actually faster to use the spider ball. I'm just gonna go the regular way this time. Alright. So you can hit the kind of front bottom of them, it looks like. Yo, there we go. All right, excellent. You know, it seems like they're really keeping the spirit of Metroid 2 here. I was kind of afraid that they were gonna that this Metroid 2 remake was gonna be like just changing Metroid 2 into a completely different game. As if like the person making it thought that Metroid 2 like wasn't like was fundamentally bad and not just like not executed the best. And what I mean is I was afraid that they were just going to completely make it into a different game. Just make it Metroid Zero Mission, except it has the story of two. But no, we're still going through the idea of, you know, exterminating the number of Metroids that are in the area. You know, that still seems to be the core way forward, is to kill all the Metroids. And then the lava lowers. So I want to get up there. But the only way to do that would be to spider ball all the way across here. And I doubt I can do that with these guys here. Because, yeah, it would have to be starting right here. Let's try it, though. Will these guys just rise up and knock me off? I'm sure they will. Yep, okay. So now we're going back to the left. To the last place that we saw lava. Oh, hi! Whoa, whoa! Okay, sweet. Oh. Purple. That's a different thing. Am I secretly timed here? Is that what I'm getting? Or is that its health? Oh, man. Okay, I think I'm starting to understand the colors. Like, blue is just don't be below it. Boom! Yeah, blue was don't be below it. Purple was getting to morph ball form. Then I had trouble with... He didn't do any other moves, really, for once I started to figure that out. But okay, cool. Surprise boss fight. That wasn't in the first one. Excellent. Let's see what's up here. Shit. Hang on now. Oh, whoops. Okay, so that I tried to do the original game's spider ball form, which is to hit down in morph ball mode. All right, so here we go. We can't morph ball up here, but we can do that. However, I'm guessing there'll just be... Okay, yep, so we can't get up there. We need to come down from somewhere else. Interesting. All right, well, let's continue our original plan to head back to where there was lava. boy.
Ah.
Secrets? This particular little keyboard voice reminds me of the music of Killer 7. Camera's a little weird here, but I understand why. Looks like we may need to be able to jump higher there or something. We can't spider ball up there because of the spikes. Yes, in. Go JRPG, taking a break from your builder game. Final Fantasy IV for DS. Yeah, I wonder about this Final Fantasy III thing. It's such a bummer. I'll contact the vendor, but I'm probably also going to end up, probably just gonna end up emulating it. Which, you know, that'll be fine. Seven Metroids around here, huh? Do I find it painful, Final Fantasy III? This side? What? Wait, what? Huh? What are you asking? You played the DS version of Final Fantasy III? Yeah, it looked really good. I never played it. I don't know why. It looked really good, though. But, I mean, that was before I ever really played any of the Final Fantasies besides 7 and Tactics. Okay, this is a perfect setup. Oh, no. There we go. Okay. Yeah, this game is weird. The way that you can just climb up walls. Like, I guess you could do this in Super Metroid too, with the wall jumps, but, yeah, it's just a, it's very weird, I think, the way that they give you so much movement in this game. I mean, you unlock the space jump later. Which is just crazy to me to do that in the second game. You know, part of the reason I really like the idea of the save points restoring your health and missiles is that this game had health and missile restoration nodes that you had to go to before. And that was a little weird to have to remember, like, where those are and stuff. Don't mind us, we're just, you know, sneaking across the cavern top here. No idea what it is I'm passing by. Oh, look at that. Whoa! Wait a minute. I wanted to I thought I would for sure be able to get up back up there. Don't mind us. Oh, yeah, I don't know. I always use us and we and that kind of terminology when I'm streaming. Oh, did not expect. Okay, let's try and manipulate it to get like up here. And now it will keep trying to swoop at us. Ah. It was a solid plan. Okay, these things are very fucking frustrating to fight. Just the way that... Ugh. The way that they turn their heads down and swoop at you. I don't know. It's a little... Bleh. Your Highness? In what context do you like it when people say Your Highness? Oh shit, oh shit. Fuck! That enemy moved very simply and I was having so much trouble with it. Okay, I have no idea where we're at now. This is great. Whoa! This is where the stiffness and the less floaty controls of compared to Super Metroid is a little bit of more of a problem. In Super Metroid, it would be pretty easy to float over those guys and shoot down at them. But this game's a lot faster than that, you know. Which is funny because Super Metroid can be a very fast game. You like the auto map up in the corner? Yeah, it looks great. How they've been doing it basically since Super Metroid. So I gotta find out how to get to these things. Weird. Aha! So to get to that, we need to spider ball in here, it looks like. Maybe from the... Oh my god. I don't really want to fight these things. These things are very annoying to fight for some reason. Because you shoot over their heads. Did that get him? Oh, weird. Played all Metroids except for the DS and GBA ones. Yeah, so you played Super Metroid and Metroid Prime 1 and 2 and Metroid Other M and original Metroid on NES, because I mean those are the best ones. Oh man, this is quite an adventure here that we've gotten ourselves into. Oh shit. Well, that's sweet. Yeah, man. I mean, I love this series of games. Please grab the ledge. Oh shit, I just recognized the song that's playing. It's from Super Metroid. Okay, let's see if we can get over here without getting zapped. Yeah. Oh no, is this thing gonna get us? Oh, I hate that. Hold on, we might be able to grab onto that ledge. Oh, fucking hell. Alright, never mind. Well, that was annoying. The bombs explode too quickly, I feel like. Like, sometimes it's nice that the bombs explode quickly because you're just trying to hop over something. But when you're trying to spider ball, when you're trying to use a bomb with the spider ball, it just explodes and knocks you off. It's annoying. I thought I was dead there because of the frozen in place spot. Why am I so irritated by these enemies? Okay, so, I mean, this place has like a bunch of garbage all around, and there's that. But not much answers as to how to get through all this garbage. Am I supposed to be using like the infinite bomb jumping more or something like that? Oh, are those all the games you had on NES? Oh, the charge beam does gather items. Wow. Okay, I did not realize that. That is very cool. That's like Metroid Prime, and I like it. I didn't even notice that that was happening. Ugh. Good job, Psycrab! What are you playing again? Oh, this is totally possible. Okay. So, let's find the correct speed. What if I just mash as fast as I can? Okay. Okay, it worked. Nice. Being that this game was made by someone who's a fan of Metroid games and not Nintendo, I wonder if they purposely put stuff like that in, or if they put stuff where, yes, you have to do that into the game. Oh, Dynasty Warriors next. I remember playing like a demo of that, and I was like, oh, yep, that's Dynasty Warriors, except it was, I don't know, I hated it. Because I don't like Dynasty Warriors. But I thought, you know what, maybe portable Dynasty Warriors could be cool. And so I downloaded the demo and played it, and was like, oh, so it's Dynasty Warriors, but I forget what it was I didn't like about it specifically at first. But I didn't like how it felt at first. And then, like, it got into those, like, touch duels and stuff. And I was like, yeah, this is not what I want out of portable Dynasty Warriors. God. Fuck. Now that I know that this harms these guys, I feel like I have to use it. I have to use this knowledge. What about Hyrule Warriors? I've never played it. I've never played it, but I mean, if I was gonna play a Dynasty Warriors game, I guess it would be Hyrule Warriors because it's, you know, Nintendo stuff, which does seem like more fun, and it probably has some fun Nintendo-y stuff to it. But I don't think it's anything that's going to make me like the general gameplay of Dynasty Warriors. Is this going to be Ice Beam now? Because I'm... Oh no, High Jump Boots. Nice. Ooh, that's excellent. And what's this? Uh-oh. Okay. Oh, hey, it's the other side of that. Nice. Cool. So then what's the deal with this? How am I to get this thing? Get it, get up there. Ah. There's probably an easier way, but I don't care. Nice. Oh, so now if I had bombed it, I could probably just hit it that way. What game is it that gives you the high jump boots and the spring ball at the same time? I think that was Metroid Fusion, but I don't remember. It's just like, hey, both of these things have been restored because you lost them earlier. And that was a very good choice, I thought, to mix the spring ball, which is a generally pretty uninteresting upgrade, to just kind of mix it in with something that is fun. Sengoku Basara? Yeah, I've heard of that. Wait, is that the one that's very lewd? Or am I thinking of something else? I might be thinking of... Yeah, I don't remember. But, I've definitely heard of Sengoku Basara. I've heard that name. Oh, shit. Alright, come over here. Yes. Whoa, that slows it down. Okay, so I shouldn't use my new strategy on those guys. Hey there, Ghost Rider. That's right. We are playing AM2R today. You can't duck fast enough. Oh, cool. Well, that was a fun little excursion. Yeah, I was talking about that earlier, that I recognize the music from Super Metroid. Okay, so what do we have that we didn't have before? Also, I want to come over here. Pop this on, and let's go. It'll be great when we find the space jump. Oh, geez. Okay, so I gotta be careful with this shit now. Yeah, they're definitely using more like Prime-y style instrumentation. Kinda like what they did with Torvus Bog on, oh shit. No. Oh, I can just jump up here now. What they did with Torvus Bog in, Metroid Prime 2. How they gave it the red Brinstar theme. Oh, that was so good. That was so good. Okay, I gotta get used to this new jump height. Bah. Can I just... Oh, I can probably just go from there, huh? There we go. So yeah, I already made it up here without the high jump because of the spider ball. But it turned out to be... not what I needed to do. Bah! Alright, so that's where that one's hiding.
Got it.
Hey, and now we can see what it was that we skipped past.
Aha, it was this place. I remember there being at least a couple of these spots
in the game where you could drop down on the rooftop area.
All right. Oh, hello. That's not a trap. Oh!
This is like a Mega Man boss.
Fuck.
Oh, thanks.
Wait a minute. What? Okay.
This is getting weird. Also, I'm getting a little annoyed about that shit happening.
Okay, well. We're missing something.
That got weird. All of a sudden, I just couldn't do damage to him anymore. We'll figure it out. I mean, all right, yeah, we'll figure it out. Okay, let's try again. Okay. Okay.
At no points during that was he vulnerable, I guess.
I wonder what these things are for up here, though.
Oh,
This game doesn't have weird shit in it where, like, I'm just supposed to have a different piece of equipment, does it? That would be pretty terrible. Or would it, though? Would it really be that bad if that were the case? Like, this guy, clearly, I cannot deal with this guy at this time. And there was a save point right in front of him. But still, I mean, I don't know. It feels a little shitty if, like, there is just something where, like, you straight up cannot... Okay, there we go. Yep, it's just me being dumb. Got it. There's something more to do. Indeed, those big electric things on the walls appear to be important, as they appear to be. They appear to be as important as they appear to be. How do you like that sentence? You know, the first time I dodged that just fine, because, like, I don't know, he did it to me in a different way, and it seemed a little less dumb. Alright, so now when he does this, what, we gotta bomb him? What exactly are we trying to do here with the bombs? There we go. Oh, and now he's a harder version of himself. Okay. Okay. Is this better than the original Metroid 2 so far to me? I think so, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Ooh, new attack. Except this is where I'm fucked, because, like... Yes! Is that it? That's it? Yes, okay. Ooh, I didn't think I was gonna make it through that at the end there. Hey, Spring Ball! Nice! That's a weird looking A, huh? Yeah, absolutely I'm enjoying this, more than original Metroid 2. This is great. I mean, I have an appreciation for the original because it was on Game Boy. It was decent for Game Boy. But as a Metroid game, I definitely like this more so far. Hey, someone should remake Fusion and make that game good too, huh? See if either of these are things. Ah, this one is. Look at that. And let's do just, you know, fill the rest of this out just a little bit. This whole area I just skipped before using the spider ball. Fusion's already. I know. I always rag on Fusion, because I know everybody likes it, and I don't. Ooh, a broken save point, that's cool. So here was the place that we shot by earlier. It's an integral part of my childhood! Hey there, Siri! Whoop! See, this game seems to have parts like that in it where I guess it started to shoot slower that time, but, like, you just can't, like, it's very difficult to duck in time for that. Like, when you land and then duck, Because you can't hold it in the air. I don't know. It feels a little weird. I suppose I could just do that. Yeah, that's probably how you do it. Wait a minute now. This is gonna loop back to the other place, right? Like I'm gonna be able to get up to where I was before? Bah! The only Prime game he played as a kid was 3? Oh, did you play Prime 1 and 2 later? Because 1 and 2 are incredible. I ended up, you know, I really liked 3 when I played it as a kid. But, and by kid, I mean I would have been like 18 at that point. Or was I? No, I would have been like 16. I don't fucking know. The Wii came out in 2006, didn't it? And then Metroid came out like a year after. So I would have been 17, I think. I just feel like I started working at GameStop after Metroid Prime Corruption came out. But I guess I don't know. Anyway, the point is, the point is, I liked Prime 3 when I was a kid, but in replaying it, I did not like it that much. It was alright. I didn't like it that much, though. But Prime 2 blew me away. Prime 2 was really good. And it goes nuts. Yes, yes, this is a fan remake of Metroid 2. Yes, indeedly doodly. Alright, so that brings me back out here. Well, what can I do out here? I don't get it. Not yet, at least. Alright, well. What does the water hold for us? Ooh, the water holds desire for a gravity suit. Hey Flex, how's wrestling? Fuck is this? Whoa! Okay, let's go. No? Not happening? Oh, destroy it! This is pretty nuts. Austin Aries is a great heel commentator. Nice. Now, who's Jerry Lawler? He's the one who still commentates, right? But he's just not a heel anymore. Or he's not a wrestler anymore, that is. He's the commentator that you complain about a lot, right? That, well, everybody complains a lot about, probably. Boy, these things are so fucking frustrating to fight. The way that they sit in front of your face and like turn their heads down even though you need them to look at you to hit them. Oh, he isn't a commentary or a wrestler anymore. Okay. I'm thinking of JBL. Okay. Alright, so here's this. I'm not sure what we do about that yet, but I'm not very maneuverable in this water. So let's see where this sends me. Pew! Whoop. Oh, you know what I found out about this game? Pew-whip. It does the Metroid Prime sucking in stuff. That's so cool. Someone's already taken this one? Is that what I'm getting? This one doesn't have his thing anymore? And I'm gonna come in from the other side. Ah, there we go. Oh, I remember this. There's all the different power-ups. Power-up balls. This was so cool. This is in the regular Metroid Prime, or Metroid 2. And there's the Varia suit. Nice. Yeah, regular Metroid 2 had that. There's this thing that doesn't hold a ball, and then in here is just like a whole room full of the balls that they hold. Oh, I forgot that I have... Did I forget that I have the spring ball? Yeah, Prime 2 is an excellent game. I still have the copy that my grandpa bought me for Christmas. So, that's a little special to me. Alright. So now we have Varia suit. That's... Oh, okay, I accidentally did that. Sweet. Yay, we did it. We solved the puzzle because I was jumping just to get through the water faster. Seems like this is fast once you fast enough once you get going. Bleh. Oh, you don't gotta tell me, Ghost Rider. I am hanging on to it. There we are. Alright, keep it moving. Oh, like all the water. We drained all the water. Wow. Cool. Except if we were destroying things that were sucking in the water, then why was the water level going down? Yup, we have the Hagrid SMB2. I should try to clean that and get it to work. No, our grandfather is no longer alive. Okay, we've seen one of these before. I'm not sure what these do yet. But it looks like this one we can get past. Thanks, Ghost Rider. Alright. Whoop. Yes, this was super easy to get. Yep, I just Googled it. There was a link to it on some download website that was totally fine. And I downloaded it and it played. Whoop. Bah. Oh my fucking god, these things. These stupid things. Can it be less irritating to fight? Jesus Christ. I'm super glad this is the main antagonist of the game, is these stupid fucking things that are insanely frustrating to fight because of the way that they move at you and the way that you have to hit them on the bottom while they swoop at you with their heads turned down. God damn, it's annoying. I've been minimizing the amount of bitching that I do about it so far, but really, it's like every time I fight one of these things, it's just like, Fuck, I don't want to do it. But okay, there we go. Funny time to ask, Anna Goes Nuts, does this one have nice boss fights? Yes! It's had a couple really cool, boss fights. No emulator, this is just an EXE, Flex. This is just a standalone program. And I'm playing it with the Super Nintendo controller. But, yes, this has had a couple really cool boss fights in it that have been really awesome. However, fighting the actual Metroid spawns I find really annoying. Down or left? Let's go down. This looks like we're gonna fight another one. Yep, there it is. Oh geez, and it's the next form. So this one has shit on the bottom of it? Because I guess they're evolving. Okay, please be slightly less you dodge too, great. Please be slightly less irritating to fight than that last one was. Like, sometimes you can get him into a little lock. If you time it right. Oh, fuck. I generally dislike enemies that like fly around with a big like amount of momentum. Where they like take these giant wide turns and that kind of thing. It's exactly why, you know the Amethyst fight in Wings of V? She throws out those shadow balls, and why I always am afraid of that attack and I always get hit by it is just because that's the way that those things move. They have a lot of like momentum and they make these giant wide turns and they get going really fast. All right, these brambles don't hurt that much, so we'll just explore the rest of this map. Next level, bat? I don't think they look like bats. But yeah, I mean, the game does have... The original Metroid 2 had, like... Oh. Okay, there we go. Now, this is the next level of them. And they have... spiny bits. Okay, and he's just fucking on me. That's cool. It's just like, it's such an annoying AI, where like you gotta jump to get it to go up so that you can hit it in the ass. I don't know, man. I hate fighting these things, and there's like 90 of them. There's like 40 of them. If this follows Metroid 2, there's 38 total. Except I think there's a point where more come out in Metroid 2. Alright. Well, that was like built up really well. The way that I fought the one that looked kinda different, he had those little legs on him. and then as I come out, the next one actually grows out into the thing that that was foreshadowing. That's really cool. Apparently there's a power up here somewhere. Where is it? Is it one of these? I don't see any that are like visually different. Map says there's a secret here, so out with it! Alright, whatever. I've lost interest. I don't necessarily think I can fight another one of those without a save. We can go save really quick, that won't take long, and that'll refill my energy. And just be safe. Be a safe thing to do. We probably have to get in there from there, that's probably how you get to that secret. Alrighty then. Wait, not this way. Alright, give it a second, please. Yeah, the save points didn't give you anything back in the original. I'm really glad that they do in this one because, right, otherwise you just have to, like, farm stuff, and that's not super fun. However, it might, depending on how they do the last area, it might make the last area a lot easier. But judging by how the boss fights have gone so far with the Metroids and stuff, I don't think it'll be much easier. I think it'll be harder. Well, there he is. Oh, it's another not quite evolved one. Ah. Stop dodging. Buh. Yeah, no hooray farming easy enemies for health. I mean, they could have just made that easier. You know, like do it how Super Metroid did it. And Ghost Rider, what are you saying? Are you saying that he specifically said, the person who made this specifically said that Metroid 2 was too easy, and so he made them harder? Because, let me tell you, he certainly made them just as annoying. Because they had annoying AI patterns in the original as well. That made them not super fun to fight. Okay, so the only area... Let me bring it over to me. This spot right here... I'm not really sure what the deal with is. But, I think once we get like the space jump or something, we can get in there. And there's a couple secrets that I couldn't figure out in here as well. We'll explore just a little bit more. I mean, we gotta be able to get this, right? Whatever is this in here? Yeah, when the missile hits the shell, it's not like it explodes and just doesn't hurt. doesn't hurt him because of the shell. No, it's just a, it's just ting. It just tings off, in the with the most irritating little ting sound possible. Boy, I really don't see the secret here. Or where it even could be. Oh my gosh, you can spring ball and that into a spider ball? Okay. That's sweet. That means like you can do this. Cool. I mean, I guess we might as well check this for bombables, right? Alright, hit me, Flex. Hit me with your secret idea. Because right now I'm thinking it might be a down and up kind of secret. Bomb everything. Okay, well, since I just found out about spring ball to spider ball, we can do this now. So that's cool. Uh-oh. Yup. Oh, jeez. I screwed it up. Bah. I can't believe that's not it. I mean, it's not going to be on this wall. I just enjoyed doing that. Straight right from the carcass. Oh. Damn, look at that. Flex Retro. He should be playing Metroid games. Nice. I didn't think you'd be able to go down there. And you explained it perfectly. Oh, remember there was also a locked door somewhere? We need to figure out what the deal with these things are. Because there was a locked door next to one at one point. Oh, there's also, and there's a locked door here. Okay, there's a thing in this game where there are things that look like this and there are locked doors next to them. We need to figure that out. So I'm excited about that. Now, I also found that you can come up here, but I didn't really get why. Whoops. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Man, it is very fun to spring ball into a spider ball. And it goes nuts, let me tell ya. When I was younger, I also could not get into any NES Metroid. I had a hard time getting into the NES Metroid game, and you know what I did? I said, God damn it. Well, okay, so my big issue was not knowing where to go, or more importantly, not knowing where I had been. So what I did was, I drew a map. I would advise, or I would, you know, just say, you should play the game, but have a notebook next to you, have some grid paper next to you, and draw a map. And write down where you find all the items and stuff. And you will see, like, oh my gosh, it's so easy to see where I've been and where I have yet to go. And you'll notice that, like, even though it seems like there's just a million places to go all the time, there's really only ever like one or two places for you to go. And then one of those will just open up another door. And it's great. It's wonderful. Okay, so it looks to me... like, we might have a thing where, like, we can go down through here. But yeah, this game's great. I would really recommend Super Metroid. Really, okay, so if it's the NES one that you couldn't get into, but you haven't played any others, I would say either do what I just said, play original. Play original, but draw your own map, dog. Slow motion bullshit. Oh yeah, the original Metroid slows down a little bit, but that's not such a big deal. But Anna, dog. I love to show this off. Yeah. Draw your own map, man. It's great. It's wonderful. And you'll learn a lot about the game in the process. You'll just learn so much. It's so much fun. So yeah, I loved playing the original Metroid that way. And it got me to just love the game. Now I can just 100% the game in less than a couple hours off memory, because I've played through it so many times now, because I enjoyed it so much when I played it that way. Or so that's option one from my advice. The other thing would be just play Super Metroid. Super Metroid is, you know, everybody knows it's the best one. Yeah, play Super Metroid. It's great. It's everything that everybody ever wanted. And so far, this game, fantastic. This game is everything that I like about Metroid Zero Mission, but without the dumb shit where it tells you where to go all the time. So... I really want to get that secret, though. Okay, it's up there. Okay, got it. So. We need to go up here. Jeez, it was an online map! That's not hardcore enough for me. I don't even recommend the Prime games. Well, it's completely different. The Prime games are completely different, and they're great. Metroid Prime 1 and 2 are very good. They're excellent, amazing games. Some of the best games ever made, you might say. You know, he's talking about not being able to get into the NES Metroid. Now, you know, those ones are a little different. That's funny, Flex. Yeah, I mean, sometimes you open up the map in Prime and you're just like, the fuck? And then you blink a few times and eventually your brain just figures it out. And then, oh yeah, I'm not looking at the bottom of it. This is gonna bring me down to where I want to go, right? Yes. Oh, but look at that. There's also a missile. Why isn't that missile pack right there? On the map. Weird. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Wow, this is very interesting. You tried Aeon Flux, or was it Axiom Verge? Yeah, Axiom Verge is awesome. It's very different from Metroid, but it's great. Wave beam, nice. Okay, I shouldn't have skipped that. Nice, we got the wave beam, boys. Sweet, I'm so glad I went back for that. Holy shit. Oh, this is gonna be so much better. Yeah, Axiom Verge is really, really good, but it is not exactly Metroid-like. It is, like, it starts out very Metroid-like, and it draws you in for how much it looks like Metroid, but then you get playing it, and it goes off in some very different directions that are very cool. Yeah, Aeon Flux is like an old anime. Or Aeon. I think it's Aeon. But yeah, that game is really, really great for other reasons. Oh, right. Okay, so there's this missile pack that I couldn't figure out. So this missile pack, what's the deal with it? I can't seem to figure it out. I already bombed all around this thing. So, let's see. Aha! Nice! Perfect. Okay. That clears this place out. So now we can go back to where we were before. Yeah. Uh-oh, this wave beam is gonna make this part weird. Whoops. I'm starting to think it might be easier just to do this. Lower Norfair? Nice. Yeah, the Lower Norfair, wait a minute, what am I thinking? Lower Norfair? You mean Ridley's Hideout? If we're talking about original Metroid? I really liked Kraid's Hideout theme in the original. That's the song that sounded like a Muhammad Suichmed solo. It kind of did that. It's like, oh man, if that was going like 10 times as fast, that would sound like a fucking Necrophages solo. Ridley... Wait, so what are you saying? Because if you say Lower Norfair, that makes me think of Ridley's Hideout from original Metroid. But you're talking about Ridley's Hideout in Super Metroid, okay. Which was probably called Lower Norfair, got it. Because it wasn't considered Norfair in the original, I don't think. The original just had Brinstar and Norfair, but then there were two more areas called just Kraid's Hideout and Ridley's Hideout. And then there was also Taurian. I don't remember. Though, if it was called that, really. So this is where the lava drained from. I don't necessarily want to do it yet, though. Shoot. I want to try and see what's over here first. Whoa! I didn't realize that thing was going to break. There it goes. Nice! This, I said it before, but this synth tone just reminds me so much of Killer 7. I mean, not anymore, but the thing is going bum 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 bum. I'm loving this wave beam. Boom. Thank you. Alright, and now there was some kind of secret over here that I didn't get before for some reason? Why was that? What happened here? Oh, right, I needed the, high jump boots. Okay, what is this trying to get me to do? Like, am I supposed to, like, jump again with extreme precision? Bah. Seems like it wants me to jump onto this and then jump off, which just seems very difficult. In any case, there's two secrets, apparently. Yeah, I am not exactly sure if I'm supposed to be able to do this. Like, am I just completely not doing it right? Or is this something I can't do yet? Gosh, it just seems like a thing I'm supposed to be doing. Wall jumping? Oh my gosh, this game has wall jumping in it. Okay, I haven't tried to wall jump yet. But that seems like a pretty good strategy here. Damn it. Am I supposed to wall jump off of these? Oh! You can wall jump off these things. Okay. Progress. Whew. That is fucking tricky dicky. Okay, so am I supposed to go all the way over to that one then? Let's try this one to that one. So we jump off like that, and then wall jump. Come on. Okay, I got another jump out of it. I see another set of spikes over there. So I don't even really know what I'm trying to do here. Like, okay, so once I get a couple wall jumps off, then what? Okay, so like, boom, boom, boom. Okay. Oh boy, this is... I want this missile pack!
Oh.
We got this. Okay, there's spikes over there, so I can't go all the way to the wall. You can't remember your favorite Metroidvania game's name? Was it... Yeah, I don't know. Castlevania Symphony of the Night? I know a lot of people really like that one. I really liked Axiom Verge. I haven't really played a lot of other ones, though. Shantae looks really fun, but I'm not sure if it's actually a Metroidvania. Okay. See, I just don't know what I'm trying to do once I get up there. Is where I'm going wrong here. So what if I jumped off that one instead? You hit the spikes. So it's like you're trying to get off those ones. Oh, a newer one. I'm really excited for Bloodstained. There's a Bloodstained Ritual of the Night coming out. That I'm definitely going to play a lot of. Oh, boy! Whoa! Whoa! My watch's display was off when I looked at it until I hit the light button, and then it came back on. That's weird. I have just a regular-ass Casio watch, and I looked down at it and just didn't have any of the display on. I've never seen that before. Okay, what if you are supposed to hit it like that, and then wall jump off the side? That doesn't seem right. What if you're supposed to do a slightly smaller wall jump off this left one? Oh my gosh. It is a Casio Illuminator. This really seems like the only thing it could be. Why is this here, though? It seems like I'm supposed to be able to... Oh my gosh, why... Why do you hit those spikes sometimes and not others? Okay, there's... That's a way to do it. Oh, good thing your Casio Illuminator is water resistant, huh? This one's water resist. I was hoping it was gonna say how many meters. Ah, I don't wear mine in the shower though. I don't wanna come out of the shower and have a wet watch, you know? Okay, that seems better. That seems like a better way to do this, but it's also very hard. Okay, what if... The problem with this... The The problem with this is that I don't see the whole path. I see that I'm supposed to wall jump off this one, and now up here, what do I do? That's my issue right now with this puzzle. It seems like I'm supposed to get up in there so I can... out of two or three? I mean, everybody likes two, right? Also, I would get the first one. Or I would get the one that's closer to the first, personally. And it seems like everybody likes Mega Man 2 more. Yeah, I don't see the full line of play here. Fuck it. I'm not doing it. I'm done. What else do we have? Let's go back over there and make sure that we got everything. Sticky ball to the right wall, close to the top. There might have been spikes up there. But either way, I don't have the dexterity to do that. I was thinking about trying to get the sticky ball, but but I saw that there were spikes kind of all around it. And I definitely... Yeah, you can wall jump into a spider ball. But I don't think I would have the dexterity to do it above where the spikes are. And even then, I'm not sure. I think there were spikes in the way, but I'm not sure. I'll come back for it at some other point later in the game when I'm cleaning up, you know? But for now, we tried enough of that. We can, however, get this now, which we couldn't get before. Hello, yellow door. What are you? Power bombs? Oh, those aren't tinking off. That's kind of funny. Hello! Hello! Oh, weird. If you hold... Okay, so we have down and up, and then if you hold both, it goes straight up. Interesting. Quick Man on PS4 Legacy Collection. Yeah, I remember there being killer lines. I thought that was in, like, Mega Man 9 or something, though. Speaking of which, any classic Mega Man play is completely on the cards right now. In the cards right now. We can play classic Mega Man whenever we want. Alright, then there's just some stuff over here. Give me that. Valdis story? I've never even heard of it. Alright, let's see what was up here. It's so weird to just be able to climb walls. But again, it's like with wall jump abuse, you can do this in Super Metroid anyway. This might be a minute. There's a lot of space up here. I mean, maybe what I should be doing is just charging through the game until I get the space jump and then just come back and have all these be trivial. Hey, there's something. Yeah. Boom! Can Okay, that didn't hit me somehow. Ooh, a secret quest line. Yeah, I love a good adventure game that has, like, quest lines that sometimes you don't even know that that's what it is, you know? Like I always talk up with like, Bloodborne and stuff, the way that they'll have, like, side quests, but they're not side, they, none of it is, it's not specifically laid out to you in that format. It's just, hey, you'll run into this character multiple times as long as they stay alive, you know, and that kind of stuff. Okay, so, yes, there was this. I did not understand. Oh, wait, what is this, though? Okay, so that's the way out. Oops. Oh. I just heard a little whoop sound. Oh, it's the morph ball sound. Ah. Okay, this is a thing, apparently. Can I please stand a little higher so I can just use the game's controls to do this? Aha, there we go. Cool. I think I lit one of those up by accident earlier. Right, left, center. Well, you're wrong! It looked like it could be either right, left, center, or left, right, center, but I ended up doing it with left, right, center. That was a weird music thing. It sounded like a boss came out. Yeah, this music changed in a weird way. It looked, yeah, that, so that puzzle was cool. It was like, it looked like it could either be left, right, center, or right, left, center. You just had to be fast. So that's interesting. What do we do now? Well, now we go down. I think I'm satisfied with our progress up here. So let's go see what's next for us. It's weird. In the original Metroid 2, you get the ice beam so soon. Nice, Crow. I love that. Man, I remember when Demon Souls first came out, and it was just like every single boss he killed in that game. You just felt great all day. Because, of course, that was back before, you know, that was back in 2009 when video games were not at all like that anymore. And now, you know, that game, we've all talked about all this in the past a million times. La Mulana, somebody bought me that game, and I have not played it yet, but yes, I do plan to play that at some point. It's a weird little shortcut. So yeah, I own La Mulana, and it will be played at some point. I just have no idea when. Okay, here is where the lava dropped, so we can now go. Very Indiana Jonesy. Okay, so there's more lava, so that's where we want to go next. You know, once we kill the Metroids and all that. Once we exterminate them. Hmm, but then there's more lava. Interesting. Oh, also, did I miss something? Whoops. Oh, spikes. Aha! Yeah, that sounds cool. La Mulana, I've seen, like, 10 seconds of, and it looks really cool. I definitely want to play it. Alright, so there's our save. Bah. Okay. What's this? Ooh, super missiles. When I saw like super missiles and stuff in this game, that's kind of what made me originally afraid that they were gonna have remade it too much. Like just make it a straight, just yes, this is just Metroid Zero mission. Instead of actually having it be, you know, Metroid 2. Okay, well, this is just a whole chasm. Perhaps. I mean, I'm excited at the notion of getting the speed boost in there. But I also want to see what this other direction is, if it's a little more palatable for, you know, early adventuring. Like, what's going on here? Oh, hey. Just some bombable stuff, huh? No reason. The screen shake? Oh, yeah. I'm generally not a fan of screen shake in games. But, yes, it can be done well. Particularly with a little bit of, you know, a little bit of restraint. Ooh, that was nice. Okay, so yep, off to the chasm. Whee! Ooh, this is very familiar. So, let's take another quick look at my original Metroid 2 map here and see if I can suss anything out. See if I can find it all where we are at anymore. So if I go to my map and we compare it to this map. Yes, I see that area and then the lava drains here. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck's going on. All right. Oh, nuclear throne. I feel like Nuclear Throne is a cool game. And I definitely think it looks like one of the better, of that kind of game that's been popular. But I don't know. For some reason, I just haven't played it yet. Okay, I remember this from original Metroid 2.
So those look like they're just there to stop you from speed boosting? Aha! What? How can this not be a thing? The flies look like platforms. If I were to have some kind of freezing thing, perhaps. Alright, well, let's get in here. Let's get into this building and see what all the fuss is. What the hell is that? Space jump! Okay, I don't wanna... I should have said something earlier, because I totally remember this place with all the dirt around having the space jump in it. That was silly looking. Oh shit. Whoops. There's a bunch of stuff back. There we go. Boom. What are these dead guys? Oh, these are the Chozo. Oh god, phase two. Oh, this is silly. This is fucking silly. Well, so far the space jump feels a lot less fucking finicky than it was in the original Metroid 2. I'm not sure if my original Metroid 2 playthrough is archived anywhere, but there was a lot of salt about how fucking finicky the stupid space jump controls were. Are there spikes down there now? Oh my gosh. Why are you just on top of me? That's stupid. Okay, those enemies are much more annoying than I expected them to be. This music kind of sucks. Pyam 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 pyam. Pyam 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 pyam. Yap 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 meow. That wasn't really getting me pumped. Wait, what? Deny the music is not GameCube Prime quality? Are you talking about the sound of it or the actual quality of it? Because yeah, like, I get that the instruments that they're using and the MIDI sounds and stuff, if they're MIDI sounds, that is, definitely sound like Prime, yeah. But the music in Prime was good, and that song was annoying and not good. But alright, check it out! So, I remember this dirt place having the space jump by it, so that's exciting. I wish I had said something. Oh my gosh, and it's so much easier to use. So, space jump's a weird thing. We can just fly now. That's a thing that was introduced in Metroid 2. The space jump that allows you to just fucking fly. You can just jump in the air as much as you want. It's very bizarre. I just don't quite understand it. When you say Prime quality, are you saying that it's as good as the music in Prime? Because I would have to strongly disagree. Yeah, Metroid 2 had... It didn't have a great soundtrack, nor did Metroid Fusion. That's another thing about Fusion that sucked, was the soundtrack was not very good. Oh my gosh, this is just like Metroid 2, huh? Oh boy. Look at all this stuff. I see. Are we gonna fight a Metro in here? You think it's as good as Prime? You are fucking crazy. That boss theme was annoying and terrible. I hate it more now that you say that you like it. No, Metroid Fusion had like one song in it. There was very little music in that game. And the one song it had was... It would play it for like a second, and then it would be back to ambience. Good God, this fucking stop doing things. Damn it. Get it. Fuck. Okay. Oh, get him. You know, if I'm gonna get hit, I might as well use up the hit to get something out of it. All right, there we go. Done. That's one less Metroid for the galaxy to worry about. Monsters. Guess after you, there'll be one less to worry about. Pew-whip. Let's climb these stairs. Alright, here we go. Ooh, is it gonna give it to me? Nice! So what's this now? Brings us out for that. Perfect. Okay, so what's all this now? Ah, the Tonberry. Yes. Which end boss took 2 hours to beat? What's all this? Oh, of all the story. Right. Do like a good end boss. I don't like a good bugged boss. Ah, look at that. Hidden missile tank. This is just fun to shoot. That kind of reminds me of Axiom Verge. There's all the digital bubble wrap, as Thomas Happ called it. Just all the destructible bricks that are just fun to destroy. Oh shit. Okay, I can't stay right there because I'll fall into that pit. What? Ah. Bah. There we go. Dead 59 times on one boss, got stuck. Whew. Okay, so up here there was some kind of thing. Does it just let you up in here? Is that a thing? No? Oh, I see. Some little speed boost action. All right. What the hell was that? Man, this wave beam is really great. This looks like the territory to do some speed boosting. Oh, yeah. Well, if by camping you mean minding their own fucking business before we come in and exterminate them, then yeah. Alright, so here we go. Speed boost time. Woo-wee! Yeah! Aww. Oh. Missiles. And then what? Is this speed boost? Which one are you playing now, Crow? Are you back on 13? Did I fight the one that explodes out of the ground? I don't fucking know. If it's like a super cool thing, I don't want any spoilery questions. But no, that doesn't sound familiar. Oh, shit. Get out of here. Alright, here we go. Let's get back over here. Equip our missiles. Unequip our missiles. Get back over here. Equip our missiles. And here we go. So we gotta come in here. Ah, I pressed the wrong fucking button. All right. Yeah. It's one of the first ones you fight? Then how would I not have done it? How would I not have done it at this point if it's one of the first ones you fight? All right. What's all this? 100% 13 too. Oh man. Aha. Okay, so we got to stop at this rock and shoot upward apparently. Damn. Oh, let's just go. Let's just go. Oh, I can't. Whoop. Got it. All right, don't gotta worry about that shit with the old space jump. Bah. A lot of enemies in this game have very annoying movement patterns. Oh shit, I remember these things. These are totally in original Metroid 2. Oh, stop it. Okay, so, probably gonna have one in here, yep. Oh, look at his little legs! Okay, get up high. I just want to tank these guys at this point. They're just, they move so annoyingly. Boy, okay. That's cool. 6 energy tanks, oh boy. I don't feel like fighting through that stuff. You know, I get the kind of thing that people do like that, like make a movie out of a game. That's the kind of stuff that I feel like starts to push the boundaries of what's legal, though. Like, somebody making a thing that specifically sort of says now you don't have to play it is sort of what I wonder a little bit about. That's the kind of thing that, like, if Square Enix had that video pulled down, I would not complain about it, you know? Because it's like, yeah, I understand. It's just it's just all the cutscenes they made for the game, with a little bit of gameplay in it. What did the person think was going to happen? Oh my gosh, I could really use, like, the fucking plasma shot now. Look at how annoying these enemies are. This is like that last boss of Axiom Verge. Someone did a Silent Hill movie? Are you talking about the actual Silent Hill movie, or are you talking about, like, somebody made a movie out of Silent Hill, the game? Yeah, of course. If it was blatant stealing, then there wouldn't be an argument to be had. Of course it's not! I hate these enemies. Oh my god, are you serious that this is the fucking enemy that you designed? It's terrible. There we've got something like that. Yeah, you know, the original Silent Hill movie I remember liking as well. It had some cool stuff in it, some good creature designs and that kind of stuff. And that's one thing that's always stood out to me about Silent Hill is how good the monster designs are. And I felt like that carried over to the movie. Those, like, little humanoid things from the beginning that, like, came up to her and we're all screaming and stuff. That was all cool. What? Oh, wait a minute. That's not how you get whatever's in there? Oh my fucking god. This thing just puts you in the corner. Getting used to my little hours. Okay, what is this? Hey, it's super missiles. Oh, and you get them from the left. Okay, interesting. Okay. Oh, alright then. Did I like the Mario movie? You know, I have not seen the Mario movie in a long, long time. I mean, when I saw the Mario movie, it was brand new. Like, I saw the Mario movie, my parents rented it from a video rental store for us to watch. Yeah, that was a long time ago. Alright, well, this is curious. And yeah, I mean, as a kid, I fucking loved it, because it was like, wow, This is a Hollywood movie, and they're talking about Mario things. To my 8-year-old, 6-year-old brain, this is the best thing I've ever seen. Oops. I think we go this way. What's going on here? Why can't I just take these? Yeah, I mean, I recall it being very weird. Like, the Koopas were like dudes and stuff. And Bowser was like Dennis Hopper or something. It was very strange. Okay, what the hell am I doing here? This all leads to a place that I'm supposed to... Oh! I get it now. Yeah, AVGN is great. I mean, I don't know so much about, like, the latest AVGN stuff. It's okay. But, like, he was, I see you, Ghost Rider. He was, I mean, everybody knows he was, like, one of the first people on YouTube. Or just on the internet. Not even YouTube, but just, like... I mean, he was one of the first guys... What? It was already down! Just doing videos on the internet about video games, you know? That was just like a guy doing them for fun and not like a review site or something like that. This thing's kind of cute now that I'm in control of it. Alright, that should probably be the last of all this stuff. Yeah, I mean, he does great movie stuff. I really liked Board James, where he talks about board games. That stuff is great. This is weird looking. Hey, and there they are, the super missiles. Cool. So this is probably Super Missile? Yeah, nice. Okay, so now that I have that, though, how do I get just that super missile upgrade pack that we saw a little bit ago? This isn't... Okay. I can now do super havoc. Get these idiot enemies out of here. I just don't even want to like do the challenge that's right here, because those enemies are so annoying. Oh, Metroid! Oh, I tinked my second one. Okay, I have to get out of here. And now, we just maybe fucking... Alright, there we go. Turned out the lava wasn't that bad compared to the enemy. Time to redecorate the place. So I guess the lava here is... Whoa! Not what I meant to do. Not what I meant to do. Get me out of here, please. Please get me out of the lava extremely quickly. Got it. Alright, we're out. Let's make it, hey there, Jad. The game's great. It's fantastic. I'm loving it so far. Let's get back to that, save point. There are things, though, that I don't like about it. Like, all the enemies move in extremely annoying patterns. Like, these guys, just get them the fuck out of my life. These stupid, diagonally moving... bot things. They're so dumb. So yeah, some stuff I don't like so much. Like, you can tell that it's made by a more amateur game developer than, you know, Nintendo R&D1. Alright, and there we go. So, it is 11:30. I think it's been a substantial stream, and I think that that's a good place for us to quit for a while. Ugh. I'm hungry. I need to go eat stuff. So, the big thing is, I really like this game so far. One big thing... is, what if I do this? Does that go to main menu? Alright. Yeah, have a good night, Anna. So yeah, I really enjoy this game so far. I think that it absolutely does a good job of keeping the game like Metroid 2, where you are looking for the Metroids and killing them, in order to progress, but they're doing a much better job at making the rest of it feel like you're moving around like a Metroid game. I like it. It's pretty cool. I'm enjoying it. And, yeah, I hope that you guys join me next time when we play some more. But for now, this has been fun, and I need to find somebody to host. But yeah, a couple things I don't like. Just generally, I think the enemies move in very frustrating ways. And, I don't think the music is... quite up to par, but it's still okay. Music's all right. All right, so what do we got going? Oh, well, Dying Camel is playing Megami Tensei 2, so I'm just gonna send you guys over to Dying Camel. I hope you guys have had a good night. I hope you've enjoyed the show. I thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you next time. Bye-bye.